Guys, welcome to the 2 a.m. Pipe on the Patio. Today, I'm smoking a Savinelli 815 Capri Root Briar. This was gifted to me. I got this yesterday from Pipe Companion, David. He sent this to me. It's an incredible note that I'm going to just keep private. But a very touching note. And I had mentioned this pipe in a video that saw him smoking this pipe, and I had mentioned what a beautiful pipe this was. And he sent it to me. And very touching thing that he did. And his note moved me tremendously. And I just wanted to thank David. David, thank you very much for that. You know how I feel about you, and you've become a dear, dear friend. And I will cherish this pipe. This pipe will get the box treatment. It will get its own box. I will make a special box for this pipe, and man, this thing smokes just wonderfully. I've been smoking this for about a half hour now, and it just smokes wonderful. And it's got a beautiful stem on it, like a lucite stem. Just a gorgeous, gorgeous pipe. David, thank you so much. I appreciate that more than you'll ever know. And as you know, it meant a lot yesterday when I got it. I was not having a good day yesterday, and this pipe came at a perfect time, and in it, I'm smoking Peter Stokeby's PS41. Which is one of my standby tobaccos that I just love. Boy, this is a beauty. So David and I have been doing a lot of video chatting with each other. And just having a great time doing it. At least I am. He's probably bored out of his mind, but I'm having a blast doing it. He sent me a story that Mark Grace told about Rick Sutcliffe. Rick Sutcliffe was pitching against the Cincinnati Reds, and he gave up back-to-back homers. When you give up home runs, or when the Reds hit a home run, they shoot off fireworks for the home team. And so he gave up a home run, they shoot off the fireworks. He gave up another home run, they shoot off the fireworks. And Rick Sutcliffe was a very intense player when he was pitching. On the days he was pitching, he got really intense. And so the pitching coach comes out after he'd given up the second home run. And Rick Sutcliffe said to the pitching coach, "Yeah, I know, I gave up a effing home run. I gave up two effing home runs. Get your butt back in the dugout and tell Don Zimmer to effing calm his butt down too." The pitching coach goes, Rick, I know you got it all under control, man. I'm just out here to give the fireworks guy a chance to reload." Mark Gray said he started laughing so hard that he blew snot bubbles. Oh man, I love those inside stories you get from guys that, you know, played the game, and their, you know, the stuff their coaches say to the pitchers and the players that you don't, you know, you never get to hear those stories. And oh man, what a great story. Well, we talked about baseball, we talked about Civil War stuff. We just, you know, we got a lot in common, David and I do, Pipe Companion. And he's just a wonderful guy, man. He's just fun to talk to. And so we've been doing a lot of chatting together and texting back and forth. And I hope to get to do a lot more with him. And we don't live too far from each other, so hopefully we'll get together soon. And so I'm planning to do a lot more of that with him. And it's just been so much fun. I mean, we spent, I think it was Saturday or Sunday. I think we talked for 3 hours on the phone, on the video chat. Just, man, it was just boom like that. It was 3 hours. We were into it. And so I'm planning on doing a lot of that with him. Just good times. David, thank you so much for this pipe, and it means the world to me. And the note was just incredible. It will stay with the pipe. It will go in the box that I make for the pipe. I need to go over to Mylon and pick out a nice box for it. Go to Michael's and get some padding and a nice satin. Cloth to put in there, and we'll make a nice presentation box for it. So this weekend I think I'm going to do some major cleaning on my 320s. I'm going to do do a full cleaning on all my 320s, do a salt treatments, and just do a full cleaning on them. And my daughter's friend that was living here with us, she got an apartment, so she's moved out, or she's in the process of moving out. She hasn't quite fully moved out yet. I'm hoping she'll be fully moved out this weekend so I can get my cellar back and my music room set up. Virginia Indian repaired my JBL speakers for me, and I've been dying to get those hooked up, and so I'm hoping to get those hooked up this weekend. I'm still haven't got my mower fixed yet. My back's been just completely jacked up, and I haven't messed with the mower at all. I need to get that work done. Need to get that done. It's supposed to be cool this weekend, so I'm hoping I can get that done tomorrow. And then Sunday, I'm hoping, I think Virginia Indian is going to come over Sunday if everything goes well. And check out his channel, Virginia Indian. Put a link below. I'll also put Pipe Companion's link below. Found a really cool 70s Lazy Boy, tweed Lazy Boy, so it'll go good with my tweed amp. And for the music room, that'll be my music listening chair. I have an old early 1900s rocker, armless rocker that I use for playing guitar in. That'll be in my music room for playing the guitar. But for listening to music, I wanted a Lazy Boy recliner. And my wife found one yesterday. God bless her. She found a Lazy Boy, tweed Lazy Boy, which I just love, tweed. And she found one perfect shape. It looks like it's in perfect shape. And lady said it doesn't have any, you know, cigarette smells or anything on it. So we're supposed to go look at that tomorrow. She wants $30 for it. Looks perfect. It looks absolutely like it's brand new. And so that will be, if everything is good on it, we'll grab that for sure. That'll be my music room chair. And my wife, she's been like, you need to get your music, we need to get your music room set up for you. You need to have your music room, which is also my cellar. And She goes, you need to get that set up. So you've been far too long without your music room, and you need to have that set up so you can play your music, have your stereo, play your guitar, and do all your music stuff again. And so she's been working on that. She's so good at finding stuff on Facebook Marketplace, and so she's looking for a CD rack for my CDs now. I have no doubt she'll find one for me. I had two CD racks when we moved here, and one of them got lost in the move, and so now I need a CD rack for my CDs, because the one that I have, I'll probably wind up using for pipes, because it's glass doors and it's a cabinet, glass door cabinet. It'll make a great cabinet for pipes. And so I'll clean that all up, maybe. It's got four or five shelves in it, and I'll just use that for pipes rather than CDs if I can get a larger cabinet for the CDs. We'll see what happens with all that. But anyway, that's what's going on here. I will catch you guys later. David, thank you again for this pipe. Absolutely beautiful. Great smoker. Just incredible smoking pipe. Absolutely love this. I will catch you guys later. Have a good one. God bless. Have a good day.